Today we're going to show you how to create a living topiary using succulent cuttings and a sphagnum moss form. These topiary forms can be found in all kinds of shapes like wreaths, spears, animal shapes, hearts, letters, and more. We ordered in succulent cuttings and also used cuttings from some of our own existing plants. If you have succulents to take cuttings from, allow at least 2 weeks for cuttings to form a callus at the location of the cut. This callus will prevent the freshly planted cuttings from rotting in the damp moss. Once you have the cuttings ready, soak the topiary form for at least 2 to 3 hours or as long as overnight. Soaking the topiary allows the sphagnum moss to become completely saturated and makes sticking the cuttings much easier. Remove the form from water several hours before using in order to allow excess moisture to escape. This will keep you from having to work with a soggy mess. Next, it's time to begin the sticking process. Pick a starting point, which will depend on the style of topiary you choose. If you're doing a sphere, also known as a kissing ball, it's best to start from the bottom. Once the bottom is done, use the hook to hang, and then the top can be easily finished without damaging already placed cuttings. For wreaths, you can really start anywhere. Using a pen or pencil, make a hole for the cutting. If the stem is large, you may have to use something bigger. Secure the cutting by inserting a pin into the form, snug against the plant. This will ensure that the cuttings stay in place once the topiary is hung. Continue this process until complete. Remember that this is a creative process and your original plan may change along the way. That's okay, just have fun creating. Items needed for your project include a topiary form, callus succulent cuttings, pins, and a pen or pencil. The Good Earth can order a variety of forms and cuttings for you, so come see us.
And remember, great gardens start with Good Earth.